Hey there, welcome back. In this video, we are going to see how you can create a dialogflow agent, and we will also see how to create some intense training phrases, bot responses, entities, etc. So let's get started. Let's create an agent first. As you can see, click this drop-down button next to the settings option and then click Create New Agent. Give an agent name without any space and click on Create. Now the agent is created. It's time to create intents. Click on Default Welcome Intent. This welcome intent is responsible for initiating the first response to the user. Default Welcome Intent is triggered when an end user begins a conversation with your agent. The agent should respond and let the users know what the agent does and what the users can say next to continue the conversation. Training phrases and their responses are there by default, but you can make changes to it and also add your own response phrases and texts, images, and rich messages like buttons, cards, etc. In this example, I've mentioned suggested replies in the custom payload, and it will show as buttons and welcome message. Now let's create more intents, training phrases, and bot responses. From the Intents tab, click on Create Intent, give a name, and save the intent. Then add the training phrases and the corresponding responses for the training phrases that the agent will show to the user. So you must be wondering, what are these training phrases? They are the example phrases that end users might say. When an end user's expression resembles one of these phrases, Dialogflow matches it with the intent and responds accordingly. You don't have to define and train every possible example because the Dialogflow uses your training data to build machine learning models specifically for your agent. So here is how a bot responds. As you can see, it is working pretty well, and also Dialogflow is having some system entities. These entities are Dialogflow mechanisms for identifying and extracting useful user input data. System entities allow agents to extract a wide range of data without any additional configuration. For example, system entities are available for extracting dates, times, emails, etc. Tick all the checkboxes to make it the required field and add a prompt for all four entities so that if the user fails to enter the required value, the agent will prompt to enter it. Then set the response for the same with entity values in the text response area. Now that we have defined the entities, let's test it with a bot live. As you can see, we provided all the details to a bot, and the bot correctly identified them. Let's learn about these developer entities. In these, you define and extract information about data that isn't covered by system entities. For instance, a company brand might create a developer entity to recognize its unique set of product names. It is also possible to create our own entities that are not included in the system entities. Go to the Entity section and click Create Entities to create your own entities. Include as many synonyms as possible for the particular reference value. Now that we have added a custom entity, let's see how a bot reacts to it. Here's the role of a custom entity. The bot asked for the appointment type, and since we trained the bot, it immediately recognizes it. This is how you create an interactive chatbot, and it's pretty easy, right? In the next video, I will show you how to integrate this Dialogflow chatbot with Telegram. Please like the video if you found it helpful, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel.